Is Tesla secretly working on a supersonic electric VTOL jet? Or will Elon launch a new company to build this revolutionary aircraft? Let's analyze Elon's remarks on that topic to find out what is the likeliest scenario.
And of course, we will also take a brief look at the current status of Tesla Gigafactory construction all around the world. Especially, Elon said some quite interesting things regarding Giga Berlin and a possible Model Y redesign. A lot to talk about as always, so stay tuned.
We all know that Elon is a fan of aircraft. I mean, everyone was wondering what the hell the bizarre name for his last child should mean. We'll not even try to pronounce it. Until he explained to us on the last Joe Rogan interview that in fact the last part of the name comes from, as Elon said, the coolest aircraft ever built, the Lockheed A-12. Why was this plane so cool? Well, this thing here was built in 1962, 58 years ago, reached a top speed of over Mach 3, could fly at an altitude of 27 kilometers, and had a range of over 5,000 kilometers. So yeah, this thing is pretty cool and Elon is definitely a fan of aircraft. Naturally then, he was thinking about ways to radically disrupt the aircraft industry. Because we know that if Elon likes something, he will create new products which normally completely disrupt an entire industry sector. He did it with electric cars. He did it with reusable rockets. He is in the process of doing it with underground tunnels, and he is in the process of doing it with neural interfaces. But over the years, he very often expressed his extremely high interest in making an, as he calls it, vertical takeoff and landing electric supersonic jet. This means a jet that can fly at supersonic speeds, take off and land vertically, and is 100% powered by batteries.
Well, I mean, the exciting thing to do would be some sort of electric vertical takeoff and landing supersonic jet.
I think the optimal sort of air transport solution is a VTOL electric supersonic plane.
I've been sort of toying with the design for an electric supersonic vertical takeoff and landing electric aircraft for a while.
Electric supersonic vertical takeoff and landing plane.
A supersonic vertical takeoff and landing electric jet.
To work on something which is a vertical takeoff and landing supersonic electric jet.
A vertical takeoff and landing supersonic electric jet.
To try to create an aircraft that is a supersonic vertical takeoff and landing electric jet.
Do an electric aircraft.
You want to do an electric aircraft?
Yeah, and the supersonic and vertical takeoff and landing actually work well with electric.
And I do think one could create an electric jet that is really exciting, something that would be supersonic, vertical takeoff and landing, pure electric.
Okay, so now we see that Elon would really like to build this supersonic electric VTOL jet. But how exactly would that look? And would Elon build the jet with Tesla or with a new company? Well, luckily, he gave us some clues over the years. Already the first time Elon was on Joe Rogan's podcast, he shared some ideas about the electric VTOL jet.
The interesting thing about an electric plane is that you want to go as high as possible. But you need a certain energy density in the battery pack because you have to overcome gravitational potential energy. Once you've overcome gravitational potential energy and you're at a high altitude, the energy you use in cruise is very low. And then you can recapture a large part of the gravitational potential energy on the way down.
Are you going to bring this to somebody? Or you just chuck
this
around?
Well, I have a lot on my plate.
Right, that's what I'm saying.
Okay, so Elon basically gave us some clues about the technical features such an electric VTOL jet would need to have. But he clearly also said that he has a lot on his plate right now, which everyone already knows, of course, and that electric cars are currently more important. Thus, we believe it's pretty safe to say that Elon won't launch the electric VTOL jet anytime soon. But how about the future? So in 3, 4, or 5 years? Would Elon maybe then launch the electric VTOL jet? And if yes, will it be under the Tesla brand? Will it be a Tesla Model V, such as rendered by Tom Abbott Davies, which even Elon himself noticed and thought it looks pretty cool. Luckily, Elon gave us even more clues. In June 2019, he tweeted that battery energy density will be high enough in the coming years to allow electric airplanes. And only a few weeks ago, Elon replied to someone saying that electric flight gets a real possibility once battery energy density hits 400 watt hours per kilogram, and said that this will only be 3 to 4 years away. But not only a 400 watt hour per kilogram energy density, which is often cited as the threshold for electric aircraft becoming viable, it's also important that the batteries should be produced in high volume and have a high life cycle.
We think that on battery day, Elon will show a clear path to achieving these battery energy densities in 3 to 4 years. Else, he wouldn't be so confident on giving quite precise time estimates on this topic. So then, a Tesla Model A or V or whatever then in 4 years? No, probably not. First of all, the magical 400 watt hours per kilogram threshold is really that, a threshold. More ideally, we should be at 500 watt hours per kilogram of energy density to allow for longer range electric supersonic VTOL jets. And also, as Elon already said, he has a lot on his plate. On Third Row Tesla in February, he clarified it a bit more, saying that he might give the idea more thought once electric cars and solar panels reach their desired scales. He added that all transport will be electric, except for rockets, which of course makes sense. So, take this info, combine it with his other remarks, and it becomes pretty clear that Elon will not build an electric VTOL jet for the time being. In 5 years, more likely 7 or 8 years, when we reach the 500 watt hours per kilogram energy density area, when electric car adoption is really becoming widespread, when Tesla solar panels are everywhere, when Tesla is really a big energy supplying company, when Starship is reliably flying to the moon and Mars, when Neuralink and the Boring Company are also working reliably without Elon needing to add much more, then we think that Elon will start working on his electric VTOL supersonic jet. And it probably will be a new company, since it will be so different from electric cars. However, it is very likely that this new company would be very closely tied to Tesla. And of course, use as much technology from Tesla as possible. Thus, we think that earliest around 2025, but more likely towards the late 2020s, Elon will launch his electric supersonic VTOL jet idea with a new company. And please consider subscribing to our channel, since we would really like to continue talking about such topics, not only about spaceflight, but also about all disruptive technologies. And we really need your support to be able to do this. And of course, you would also have our everlasting gratitude.
So what else is happening in the world? A lot, as always, at the gigafactories. So let's start with Giga Austin, because the speed of progress there is just insanely mind-boggling. Now you can already see the outline of the future Giga, or probably more accurately, Terra Factory at Austin, Texas. The footprint will be massive, as you can see. The whole area is now dry and flat. Not long ago, we still had many ponds and the area was extremely uneven. But now, many pile drivers are around, which have the goal to drive piles into the soil in order to provide foundation support for the massive factory structure. Joel Techmeyer even showed us how the factory will possibly look, with two separate buildings and a long corridor in between. Thanks a lot for your great work again, Joel. We believe that the factory will be finished already in quarter one next year, as insane as it sounds. But Giga Texas is just progressing so fast, so it's really possible. Thus, the Cybertruck might also launch earlier than expected, maybe even by mid-2021. At Giga Shanghai, meanwhile, only last week, we were shown a cool video of the assembly process of Model 3 at Giga Shanghai. It looks like the alien dreadnought factory that Elon was often talking about. meaning a fully automated assembly line, the machine that builds the machine, so to speak. And since the first made in China model-wise have already been spotted in China, it's pretty clear that Model Y will launch very, very soon over there. But Giga Berlin is the most exciting one here, because Elon visited Berlin last week and had some highly interesting stuff to say. The factory itself is being built with crazy speed as always. And German politicians are so astounded that something can be built so fast in Germany that Giga Berlin is now being cited as a role model for other construction projects in Germany. Tobias Lindt uploaded a video onto his channel where Elon sheds a bit more light onto some projects for Giga Berlin. Thanks a lot, Tobias.
First of all, he said that battery construction will indeed happen at Giga Berlin, that there will be a huge party to celebrate the opening of Giga Berlin, and why it is so important to build the factory as fast as possible. Of course, to transition to sustainable energy and transport as fast as possible. He added that the paint factory will be the most advanced of any Tesla Gigafactory worldwide. The most interesting thing, he said, we at least found it the most interesting, was that the Giga Berlin built Model Y will not just be a copy of the US or China built Model Y, but it will actually be a radical redesign of the core technology of building a car. He said he will tell us more about that on Battery Day on the 22nd of September. And he emphasized that it will be a really big thing. Consider us intrigued by this announcement.
We believe that this doesn't mean that the European version of the Tesla Model Y will look radically different or have a radical exterior redesign. So probably no Cyber Model Y. Sorry. Although we have to say that we really like that idea. But no, this means that the way Model Y will be built at Giga Berlin will be radically new, probably employing the new single-piece casting machine, which will completely and utterly revolutionize the way cars are being built. This casting machine will drastically reduce the number of pieces the Model Y will have. You can see this in these renders here, as shown for the Model 3. From 70 pieces of metal for the rear underbody to only 2 pieces, eventually 1 single piece. This not only reduces building time and makes the whole building process a lot faster, but of course will also massively reduce building costs and thus even further increase the profit margin per car. Thus, the European Model Y will not only be a much simpler car, having fewer pieces, and probably thus being even safer, but no, it will generate a lot more revenue per car for Tesla. Highly interesting stuff, we have to say. And we really cannot wait to learn more, as Elon said, on Tesla's Battery Day on September 22nd, which is luckily not so far away anymore. And if you missed our last week's disruption report, where we talked about the Tesla stock rally, and analyzed when Tesla will become the world's most valuable company, you can check it out right here.
So then, thanks as always for watching the JS Disruption Report, and then I would say, on to the future! Yeah!
And talked about...
We think then on...